Greetings and welcome to my mess. This is my little cockpit in my little studio in my little town of Mount Eliza in Melbourne, Victoria, Australia. And yeah, this is where I work if you're interested. It's kind of messy, but it does the job for me. So behind me I've got a couple of Fender amps, classic Fender amps, and quite a few fabulous guitars. At my feet I usually keep an MFC 101, which is the fractal control interface. In fact, there it is there. On the other side, I've got the Ironheart, which is a fabulous preamp by Laney, yet to be demoed. Sorry, guys. And I've got an SM Pro Audio M-Patch 4 M2 interface, all of the monitors and speakers and interfaces, along with an 11R underneath it, which sadly hasn't seen much work. Behind me is my favourite 56 Relic Strat and a fan to keep me cool in the heatwave. That's not why we're here. We're here because I have to travel across the country to a place called Perth in a couple of days, and I know that I have to travel, one, very lightly, and I have to travel, two, to a basement on the other side. That's what I know is the only available amp for me to hire as backline. So I've had to put something together to suit that amp, and in fact, I've dragged my Achilles version of a basement, a very nice 59 recreation, almost to the screws, and the closest possible speakers that my friend Labros at Achilles could get hold of. So I've put it out and I've set up what I anticipate to be a fairly light pedal board arrangement consisting of this M13 that I was lucky enough to score for, well, you'll be jealous, but under $200, I think, after all was said and done. And a couple of excellent Mission pedals, which are relatively new, to control it all. On the left is the Mission Rewire Pro, which I've programmed to have jumper switches 1, 2, and 4 on and 3 off as per their favourite settings. That gives me a bit of extra gain and some wider centre frequency, I believe. I'll have to check that. I could be completely wrong. And the EP1R, which is an expression pedal. Now, the M13 is an older multi-effects board, but it sounds pretty good with the bassman. I can only take one guitar, so I'm taking this quite wonderful Smitty S-Style, which Eric and I collaborated on specifications-wise. It's a quarter sawn maple neck, one piece of maple, one piece of swamp ash, in a lovely sky blue. Well, it was supposed to be a sky blue, but it's turned out like this, and I still love it. And it is equipped with Mick Brierley's Rebellion pickups, which run at about 9K. They're A2 magnets, so they're not as spiky as most Strat pickups. They have a lovely warmth, but still some jangly sound, as you will hear in a moment. So I should probably shut up and give you a listen to what it sounds like. Now, the reason for this is, I'll just backtrack a little bit. The reason for the M13 is because it weighs in at about 5 to 6 kilos, maybe another kilo with the pedals, and it should, in the end, with a little bit of persuasion, all fit into this gig bag, which will go into my, like a gym bag, jock bag. The Zoom G5 is another great pedal, but you have to switch to and from some of the effects, and I need to get at most of mine pretty quickly for this particular gig that I'm doing. But the G5 does a lot, much, much more than the M13, and a demo for it is coming shortly. Laney boys, love those Laneys. All right, let's have a listen to this little setup. I'll shut up. Okay, so firstly, the clean sound, and I'm running the basement at about the volume that I think I'll be running it on stage, although that tends usually to go up a little bit. That's why I'm using an S-Style or a Strat, because I know that it won't drive the basement too hard. I can use pedals to give me some overdrive. So anyway, here's a clean sound. Bottom knob here is wound in as a tone control for the bridge pickup. And you can tell why I love these pickups so much, because they just sound ace. So first of all, the Mission Rewire Pro, which I'm enjoying a lot because of its simplicity, and I love the purple colour. And I think that it sounds better than the wires that are available in the M13, so I've decided to bring it, even though it's a little bit of extra weight, as an extra pedal, because it's cool. So it's kicking out a bit of extra grain to drive the amp a little bit harder. That's cool. That's how I like it. The expression pedal is not doing a lot, except maybe altering some of the speeds on phases and things like that in the M13. For instance. Now that's the M13's script phase, so if I wanted to use a little bit of, you know, doobie funky stuff. And I like that pedal because it feels good. It feels positive. It feels like a heavy-duty quality pedal that, you know, stage-worthy. You can stomp on it, and it's going to be great. Back to the clean sound again. I don't need this much. I don't need much in terms of effects for this gig with James Rain, who I'm playing with on the weekend. There's a huge outdoor concert that we're doing as a pub show. So basically, I need a decent compressor, something like a tube screamer, and I usually like two shades of full-on dirt for rhythm and lead stuff, plus a chorus and some reverbs and delays, which is quite a lot to ask for in a big pedal board. The M13 can cope with all of that quite well. So first of all, back to the clean sound again. Here's my compressor. It's actually the M13's boost comp, which drives the amp a little bit harder, gives it a bit more girth. So I'm using it like a clean boost and a drive pedal. It sits well behind the other drives, as you will see. Now, if I need to play some country sort of picking, which I do, I hit the old echo preset over there in the fourth slot on the M13. Stick the compressor behind it. If I need to get dirty, I've got a little tube screamer preset here. Switch the echo off. Now the wah behind that sounds pretty cool. Up here I've got a nice filthy rhythm tone which backs off well. It's called the classic distortion, and I'm not sure which pedal that's modelled after in the M13, but that's what it says here. If I want some delay or some ambience behind that, I can hit this pedal, which is the analog with modulation delay. Down here I've got a chorus. It's quite subtle. In fact, I might make it a little less subtle by turning the depth and mix up here. That's better. Put the compressor behind it. Beautiful. That means I can get my lovely 80s jangle tones, and there is some call for those in this set that I'm doing. Over here in the middle, I've got another drive, which is called the tube drive. Now, if I put the compressor behind it, drives it a bit harder. Of course, also the tube screamer. I've got a reverb here. Just the spring reverb. It's not mixed up. In fact, I think I'll turn it up a little bit. Again, with the compressor, some all sorts of beautiful stuff can happen. Very nice. I can't even remember what I put down here. Oh, that's our analog delay with modulation, of course. Up here, I've got a 63 spring reverb. This is a digital delay with modulation that I can tap in. In fact, I can tap the tempos into all of the delays. That's how the M13 works, which is pretty cool. That's kind of good because that gives me a little bit of modulation, like a chorusing effect as well, which I sometimes prefer to use more so than a chorus pedal, which can be extreme, but it's going to work well for big soaring solos. Just love that mission pedal, it's a killer. And I've got the slapback. And down here, a bit of a luxury effect which will probably hardly ever get used, but it is a auto volume echo. There it is, my friends. Everything I need. Three shades of dirt, a compressor, some modulation, phaser. It's light. It's going to end up in a bag not much bigger than a laptop inside my tote bag. One guitar to do it all, and a basement at the other end, which I hope sounds as good as that one. We'll see. I'll report back. See you soon.